Captain, vessel approaching bearing 161 Mark 204 on an intercept course. It is a Chodak dreadnought.
Shields up! Red alert!
We are being hailed.
Don't fire on us.
On screen.
Well, Captain Picard, you humans are more resourceful than you appear. Prepare to die.
Hoping that the device just destroys them, let's maybe not fire in response.
The dreadnought is arming weapons. They have locked onto us. They are closing.
Evasive maneuvers. Don't fire.
Evasive maneuvers.
They did not fire. I do not understand. Sensors indicate that their systems are functioning normally.
They're trying to get us to fire so the thing will destroy us.
I sense hostility, but also deception.
I don't need to be from Beta Zed to figure that out.
Were they bluffing? Trying to get us to fire first?
Mm-hmm.
Captain, we've just intercepted a transmission between the Dreadnought and the Unity device. It is a coded binary signal.
Oh.
The transmission is opening a large access port on the surface of the device.
We should go there.
The Dreadnought has launched a shuttlecraft. It is heading towards the access port. The Garidian vessel is also launching a shuttlecraft.
Okay, I'm guessing we're going to go automatically there because I don't have a way to go to the shuttle bay.
Mr. Worf, assemble a security team and meet me in shuttle bay 3. Data, you're with me. You have the bridge, number one.
Captain, I must...
I don't argue with your captain.
I know what you're going to say, Will, but I'm not going to stay here and let those people decide the fate of the Federation for us.
Understood, sir. Good luck.
You stay in line, number one. I always thought they should have given Riker more of a personality.
Sir, according to the ship's sensor reports, both the Garidian and the Chodak shuttlecraft landed nearby.
Okay, we have this lady with us.
I see no signs of either landing party, Captain.
We'll have to find out which way they've gone. They have superior knowledge of the device and a head start.
Mm-hmm. Butler.
It's Ensign Butler, one of our engineering officers.
Okay, we got an engineering officer.
It is Ensign Butler, an engineering officer.
And Worf's with us, yay.
It is Ensign Butler, an engineering officer. It is our shuttlecraft.
Anything else to see? What's this, interior bay?
There is a large bay in that direction.
The moon.
It is only a moon.
Oh!
It's our shuttlecraft. It's a moon. There's a large bay through there.
Short and succinct. See what she has to say about our teammates, crewmates.
It's Lieutenant Worf. It's Lieutenant Commander Data.
She talks very fast, doesn't she?
It's Captain Picard.
It's our shuttlecraft, the Poincaré.
The Poincaré.
It's one of several planetary bodies orbiting the Unity device.
Oh, crap. Yeah, that's right. The moon is not orbiting a planet nearby. The moon is orbiting the freaking Unity device. That's how big this thing is. Wow.
There is a large chamber that way.
Thing has its own moon.
It appears to be in a synchronous orbit around the Unity device. The shuttlecraft is fully operational.
Oh, I'd hope so. We need to get back at some point.
The opening leads to a large bay.
There is a large bay in that direction.
Alright. Let's go in that direction. Saving. Fluid.
It does not appear to have any bearing on our mission.
Shuttle? Oh, you're gonna go all the way that way? Exterior bay.
Stop where you are, sir. There's something funny about that circle on the floor.
You are correct. The pad is the focal point of a transporter. Anyone stepping onto the pad will be beamed to a receiving station elsewhere in the device.
Maybe one of us should go through the transporter and report what they find.
The Chodak and Garidian landing parties must have used this transporter.
Indeed.
We did not come here for sightseeing. The Chodak and...
I just want him to look at it. Not ready to do that yet. I'm not sure if I want to send Worf. I might send the ensign.
It looks like part of the life support system. Fascinating.
It could be part of the life support system. The conduits connected to the device appear similar to the transporter transmission lines used on the Chodak planet Alanor. Intriguing.
I think it filters the air.
Filters the air.
This seems to be the focal point of the chamber. Nothing unusual here.
We should be cautious around these Chodak devices.
Yeah, don't get yourself teleported somewhere unexpectedly. So... we didn't even bring our security rod with us. We should have brought the security rod, right? Just in case. Well, obviously we don't need it, but...
it's an oxygen regenerator
device? Huh.
It has been used recently. It has been used recently.
Okay, now we know that's there.
The device divides carbon dioxide into its component elements.
These things breathe out carbon dioxide? Well, we're breathing oxygen.
The device is a transporter which appears to be activated automatically. The circuits have been used several times just prior to our arrival.
It absorbs carbon dioxide and releases oxygen.
Okay, releases oxygen.
It's some kind of transporter. I'm getting residual energy readings.
It is part of the life support system. The device is a transporter. It seems to have been used recently.
Who should go through?
We'll have to use the transporter.
The transporter is activated by stepping on the pad.
Butler?
One of us should go through the transporter first and report what they find.
Just one of us?
I should go first in case the Garidians or the Chodak are waiting in ambush.
Well, he's indicating he wants to go first. Maybe we should send him through.
That does not work.
No, you don't use it, you just walk up to it. Okay.
Stop where you are, sir. There's something funny about that circle on the floor.
We already know what it is.
You are correct.
Maybe one of us should go...
now what?
We haven't heard...
Butler?
He isn't reporting back.
Yeah, can't help but notice that.
We have not received a report.
Well, maybe all of us should go through. There's nothing else to do. Here, right? Apparently. Can we walk around all this crap and go to the shuttle?
See the Garidians anywhere.
Oh, not you. Oh, you went through it. Okay. Just want to look at it.
This is the Goridian shuttlecraft.
Right.
He isn't reporting back.
Neither of them are.
We have not received a report.
Okay, so all of us should go through it, I'm supposing.
Where is the rest of my team? My phaser and tricorder are gone.
They appeared somewhere else?
I don't see any means to operate it from this end. I'm not certain what it is.
The glow.
Fascinating.
Well, I can't analyze. We can walk off that way and we can... I don't know. Check out this glow.
Welcome, Jean-Luc Picard.
Well, howdy.
Chosen representative of the United Federation of Planets. You have done well so far. If you prove yourself worthy in these final tests, the Unity device will be yours.
Final tests? You mean there have been other tests and these are the final tests? Where's my away team?
Where is my away team? Whoever it was is gone now.
Huh.
The apparition has vanished.
Okey-doke. Then we're going this way. For final tests and stuff.
I have examined the shuttle. It will only launch with three passengers.
Who's he talking to? Oh, one of the Goridians?
Captain Picard!
Yes? Where's my away team?
Where is my away team?
We don't know. Our team also disappeared when we went through the transporter.
They're splitting us up into leaders, like they... recognize us from before, at least anyway.
Their fates are insignificant compared to the matter before us.
I have to disagree there.
If they have died, at least it was for a good cause.
What do you know about these tests?
The Chodak rebels who sent the Unity device into the future set up a number of tests to ensure that whoever found the device was worthy of its power.
So it's me against these two.
It appears that we have been chosen to compete for the device.
Neither the Goridians nor the Federation has any claim to the device. It rightfully belongs to the Chodak.
I don't think anyone should have it. I mean, look how advanced they were. And it corrupted them, or they used it unwisely. And they were more advanced in some ways than the Federation. No, none of us should have it.
We shall see. It seems to me that we are all on an equal footing here.
For the moment.
Mm-hmm.
This shuttle will take us to the Unity Device Control Complex.
Okay. Going on the shuttle?
Fascinating. There seems to be no end to this grid work.
Huh.
It is a vehicle of some kind. It appears to be capable of carrying three passengers.
What a coincidence!
It is difficult to assess Admiral Brodnack's character.
I definitely don't trust him.
Captain Pentara has proven herself honorable in the past.
Mm-hmm.
It is a...
Okay. Walk to the shuttle. It's just like Space Mountain.
I would like to know more about the tests we face.
I do not know exactly what form they will take, but trials and tests have always determined rank and position in Chodak society.
How powerful is the Unity device?
It can alter physical reality anywhere in the galaxy.
The wreckage of the Romulan and Chodak fleets clearly demonstrates its potential as a weapon.
Its capabilities are infinitely greater. Theoretically, the Unity device could be used to unmake the galaxy.
Then it would indeed be a catastrophe if it fell into unscrupulous hands.
Unscrupulous yep. or incompetent, even a well-meaning master could wreak havoc with its power.
That's the problem.
What do you intend to do with the device, if you should get it?
Trippy, man.
The ancient Chodak brought this power into the universe, and we accept that responsibility. We will rebuild the Chodak Empire and control the Unity device ourselves.
Viridian society is on the verge of anarchy. It will take something as powerful as the Unity device to restore order. Our need outweighs your fantasy of empire building. And you, Picard?
The Unity device is too powerful for any one race to control. It must be used for the common good. Perhaps its power can help establish a lasting peace between our peoples.
You speak of my fantasies, Pentara. We are about to dock. May the worthiest species prevail.
I think it has to be destroyed. This looks very, like, drawn. Like, completely drawn, like...
I will check the far door. You two check the others.
I don't know. Maybe I'm just noticing it, but it looks different than the others. It looks completely like someone drew this and shaded it in. I can't do anything.
Your words made much sense to me, Picard. You and I should work together. Our governments may not be allies, but at least we share many of the same values. If Broadneck gets the device, we both lose.
I don't trust her. I mean, their society is on the verge of anarchy. They can't even police themselves. How can they be trusted with this device? Someone will probably take it over and then try to use it to destroy the Federation, and they'll have it for themselves. Any number of scenarios could pop up as a result of this, of us sharing this. We could do the same thing. Somebody, you know, in our government or society, rather, could take this over.
I have no way of knowing whether or not I can trust you.
Well, she's happy about that.
Captain Pentara, it is difficult. I don't see any way to make the shuttle return to the outer shell. The doorway leads to a large chamber. There's a symbol on the door. There's a symbol.
Check the other doors.
I wonder when the tests will start.
She didn't have anything to say back when you said we couldn't trust her.
A force field blocks the doorway. I can see some sort of pedestal in the room holding a sculpture or symbol of some kind.
It would be better if this was facing toward the doors, like the camera being here or something.
The doorway leads to a large chamber.
Well, it's another Picard.
Do not be alarmed, Jean-Luc. Using the power of the Unity device, I have returned from the future to warn you.
Oh?
Do not trust the aliens. They will betray you and take the device for themselves. Take this artifact. It will help you. Help us win the Unity device for the Federation.
Picard. Picard, are you with us?
Kinda.
I just received some kind of visitation. A being claiming to be myself from the future warned me that you too would betray me.
How can there be betrayal where there is no trust to begin with?
Well, you got a point there.
It's probably some kind of a trick to make us suspicious of each other.
Did you two also see somebody talking that looked just like you?
Yes, let's get on with it.
We're surrounded by force fields. This is some kind of a trap.
Hmm. What do we have here?
Fascinating.
We have an artifact.
It is difficult to... Captain Penta...
Exit.
The force field will lower when one of us passes this test.
What is the test?
This table is the apparatus for the second challenge, one of the oldest of the Chodak tests.
What is this second challenge?
It is a test of stamina and cunning given to Chodak youth. It is used to cull the weak and feeble-minded before resources are wasted on them.
Yeah, what exactly are we being tested on? Like, how do we pass? Are we supposed to be pure of mind? Are we supposed to be sneaky, resourceful? Like, what are we supposed to do?
How does it work?
You will find out once the test begins.
That is hardly fair.
The Chodak have spent many millennia preparing for this day. I have spent my entire life getting ready to pass these tests. Is it fair that I give up the advantage I have earned?
No comment.
If you are truly the most worthy, then explaining the test to us won't put you at a disadvantage.
Very good point.
It will make your inevitable victory all the more noteworthy.
Haha.
Very well. Pick up these semicircular blocks.
Well, we have a way with words, don't we?
When it is your turn, place one or both blocks in the receptacles. Picard, your left receptacle targets me. The right one targets Captain Pentara.
Okay, he's left, right is her.
Then push the button. A jolt of energy will be delivered to one or both of the others. The last one standing passes the test.
When will the test begin?
Momentarily.
What? I missed that.
The force field appears to emanate from this device. The force... The lower air gap is larger than the upper air gap.
Hmm.
The field energy jumps across the air gap to the field emitter.
Well, there must be some reason we can examine this and all its parts.
The force... The force... It did not work. It did not work. I cannot use this with that.
Huh.
I cannot use...
What's this thing?
They're semicircular metallic blocks. They're fascinating.
Field coil. I didn't see that.
The force field energy passes through this coil, out the field emitter, and returns to the common terminal. If I can somehow make the lower air gap smaller, the field energy would jump directly to the common terminal and bypass the field emitter entirely.
Make the lower air gap smaller.
It did not work. It did not work. It did not work. It did not work. I cannot use this with that.
Well, I don't know how we make it smaller.
It did not work.
Common terminal.
The field energy must return to this terminal to complete the circuit.
Hmm. Well, don't know. We don't really have a lot of things to mess around with.
The force field appears to emanate from this device. It did not work. The force field... It did not work.
Okay, let's go back out then, I guess.
The table contains the apparatus for the Unity device test. This activates the device.
Receptacle?
Placing a block in this receptacle will target Captain Pentara.
What if I use this thing?
It did not work. It did not work. It did not work. It did not work.
Hmm. Exit. Is there anything else to look at in here? Other than this field generator?
Captain Penta. It is difficult. There must be another way out of the chamber besides submitting to this test.
Such as?
I don't know yet.
When you figure it out, let me know.
Pentara, we should work together now.
You had your chance already.
Oops.
The situation has changed. Brodnak will almost certainly defeat us both if we do not join forces.
All right. If we concentrate our efforts on Brodnak, we should be able to overcome his superior stamina.
He has superior stamina?
Never mind. There must be another way to solve this.
We are here to face these tests, not avoid them.
With a little ingenuity, we could disable the force field generator.
Yeah, what items do you guys have?
What you suggest is not to my advantage.
Right, you could lose.
You could lose, Brodnak. And where would that leave you? If we cooperate, we can all get out of here together.
I will not fail.
I wonder what this thing is and where we picked this up. Did I just space on that?
I refuse to take part in this.
Then you will die first. It is your turn, Captain Pentara.
We will defeat you, Brodnak.
You are both weak.
Yeah, I wasn't supposed to do that.
It is
my turn. What was the left was him?
It did not work.
Does he say which one I was saying?
Placing a block in this receptacle will...
Right, okay.
Give up, Admiral. Pentara and I have agreed to join forces. You cannot withstand both of us.
That's right.
Come now, Picard. The test has barely begun, and you claim victory already?
Every Garidian will be dead before the first Shodak steps on Garidian soil.
If that's the way you want it. It will be interesting to see which of you falls first.
Well, he gets to zap us both.
It is your turn, Captain Picard.
Oh, we're gonna keep that in there, okay.
You're losing, Admiral. If you agree to give up your quest to rebuild the Chodak Empire, we can work together and find another way out of here.
Right.
You don't understand. Membership in our empire would improve your species.
Yeah, by becoming second-class citizens? Somehow I doubt that.
I like my species the way it is.
That's a line from Worf. I like my species the way it is. I'm not completely sure, but I think he said it to Q? I gotta look that up now. How much energy do you have left?
We will defeat you, Broadneck.
I have sworn to regain the Unity device for my people. It is the destiny of the Chodak race.
Yeah, destiny.
But I have failed. Before you kill me, promise that you will use the power of the device wisely.
What about the other tests?
I have no desire to kill you, Admiral, but we cannot allow you to rebuild the Chodak Empire by conquest.
Can we? Do we have to kill him?
But our intentions are benign. You would be happier under our leadership.
Benign. You have a funny idea of benign.
Finish him now, while we have the advantage.
Yeah, I'm not gonna necessarily do that.
Even if we defeat Broadnack here, the Chodak will still have to be dealt with.
The Unity device will take care of them.
Everyone, including the Chodak, must be protected from the misuse of this power. Yeah, I'd rather just destroy it, but
no. Everyone, including the Chodak, must be protected from the misuse of this power. A council representing all civilizations should be created to control the device. We need you to convince your people of that. Will you help us?
The thought of untested species using the Unity device is almost unthinkable.
Almost unthinkable. Not quite, though.
But there is wisdom in your words, Picard. I will cooperate.
Awesome. Hope he's being sincere.
Good. Now, let's find a way out of here.
How do you intend to disable the force field, Picard?
I don't know. You have any goodies inside that thing of yours?
I don't know yet.
We'll have to work together. We have to stick something in the space, or move the thing. I don't know. What do you think?
How do we disable the force fields?
I don't know yet.
How do you intend to disable the force field, Picard?
I don't know yet.
I don't know yet. That won't help now.
It won't talk to us. Can I get my thing back? What kind of test is that, anyway?
It did not work. It did not work. I cannot use this with that. These blocks from the test are metallic, and together they're exactly the right size to fit into the lower air gap.
Excellent. Now we got a full disc.
It's a metallic disc. The blocks fit, but it will take all three sets to disable the force field.
Ah, so now we really have to trust ourselves. They have to give, well, they have to trust me and give me their blocks.
I need all the blocks from the test.
Take them.
Here.
Well, that was easy. Oh, I took them apart.
I cannot use this with that.
Alright, so that's all we do is, otherwise it takes it apart again.
It worked. The field energy has been redirected to the common terminal.
Yay, teamwork! No iron team.
Making the lower air gap smaller than the upper air gap redirected the energy flow away from the field emitter. It worked. The field energy has been redirected to the common terminal. Making the lower... The field energy must return to this terminal to complete the circuit.
Looks like... we're successful.
Make it so.
Let's get out of here. Exit. Stuff. Look at. Examine. Exit.
There. The force field is down.
You humans are resourceful.
Mm-hmm.
Now what?
It's a very good question.
Captain Pentar. It is difficult.
I don't know why I'm looking at that.
Fascinating.
Well, I guess we're heading this way. Let's talk to these guys first.
The Unity device is almost ours.
We're waiting for you, Picard.
I still don't fully trust these guys, especially him.
I believe that symbol on the pedestal is the key to the door leading to the control center.
Hmm.
Use the artifact I gave you, Jean-Luc.
Oh, he gave me the artifact. Is that really him from the future?